Святогая, щоб не сказав то, що ви були прищені Боє ім'я. Хрестив я теж дім Стефана, і більш не знаю, чи хрестив я кого іншого. Христос попослав мене не хрестити, а благовістити, і то не мудрістю слова, щоб хрест не став безуспішним. По слову про хрест клопотатим, що погибають, а для нас, що спасаємося, сила Божа.
Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Do not be carried about with diverse and strange doctrines, for it is good that the heart be established by grace, not with meats which have not profited those who have been occupied with them. We have an altar from which those who serve the tabernacle have no right to eat. For the bodies of those beasts whose blood is brought into the sanctuary by the high priest for sin are burned outside the camp. Therefore, Jesus also, that he might sanctify the people with his own blood, suffered outside the gate. Therefore, let us go forth unto him outside the camp, bearing his reproach. For here we have no continuing city, but we seek the one to come. Therefore, by him let us continually offer sacrifice of praise to God, that is, the fruit of our lips, giving thanks to his name. But do not forget to do good and to share, for with such sacrifices God is well pleased. Духові Твоєму.
Хрумовість, о Божий.
Воскреші, алелуя, алелуя, алелуя.
Алелуя, алелуя, алелуя.
путь собі поживи. Ісус сказав їм, не треба їм відходити, дайте ви їм їсти, вони ж моблять до нього. Ми маємо тут тільки 5 львів і 2 риби. Тоді він каже, принесіть мені їх сюди. І лише народові сісти на траві, взяв 5 львів і 2 риби, підвів очі до неба, поблагословив і рознавав хліби і дав учням, а учні людям. І всі їли до наситу і назбирали кусків, що зосталися 12 кусків повних. Ті же, що їли було, яких 5 тисяч чоловік, окрім жінок та дітей. І зараз же заставив учню увійти до човна і перевести на той бік раніше від нього. Тим часом, як відпускав народ, Jesus spoke these words. He lifted up his eyes to heaven and said, Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, that your Son also may glorify you, as you have given him authority over all flesh, that he should give eternal life to as many as you have given him. And this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. I have glorified you on the earth. I have finished the work which you have given me to do. And now, O Father, glorify me together with yourself, with the glory which I had with you before the world was. I have manifested your name to the men whom you have given me out of the world. They were yours, you gave them to me, and they have kept your word. Now they have known that all things which you have given me are from you, for I have given to them the words which you have given me, and they have received them, and have known surely that I came forth from you, and they have believed that you sent me. I pray for them. I do not pray for the world, but for those whom you have given me, for they are yours, and all mine are yours, and yours are mine, and I am glorified in them. Now I am no longer in the world, but these are in the world, and I come to you. Holy Father, keep through your name those whom you have given me, that they may be one as we are. While I was with them in the world, I kept them in your name. Those whom you gave me, I have kept, and none of them is lost, except the son of perdition, that the scripture might be fulfilled. But now I come to you, and these things I speak in the world, that they
Ті, що не знають історію, повторюють повну історію. А історія нам каже, що церква мала питання, хто то є Ісус Христос. І ті перші 6 речі з тобою нам пояснили, що Бог не один у святій Тройці, а Ісус Христос – одна особа, дві природи. Одна особа, дві природи. І вони так нас через церкву вчать. Я на вас дивлюся і думаю, що з вас всіх, Боже, три хрестяться так, як нас всі сьогодні церква через цих отців. До вас звертаюся, якщо ви не можете це зробити і це поставити, то які ви православні християни? Яка ваша віра? Розумієте, що я кажу? Якщо все не можете зглазити свої пальці так, тоді що тут є? Може, тут є добре, але так, то не є віра, що нас, нам Бог дав за тих отцях. Так що до вас сьогодні звертаюся тим праздником. Я даю вам дарунок. Ви мені, нам тут даєте дарунок, ваше пришестя. Багато наших парафіянів тут нема. Поїхали по твоє літо. Навіть Бог, здається, часто вирішає на дачу свою. Але приїхали, поїхали на дачу, а ви тут їхте місце берете. Богу дякувати. Чи вони в Україні, чи десь на Ковача Біч, чи десь в Америці, на Флориду. Чому не в Флориді, я не знаю, а там так здесь не зробили. Вони приїхали від нас. Але ви, так що я вам даю цей дарунок, що церква нам дає собі тому віддання, що Бог таким способом узнається у нас. Щоб ми принаймні хрестилися по православному, так як наші предки перед нами, без слів показати їм через вулицю, без слів показати тим своїх храмах, мормонам, без слів показати нашим баптистам, добрі люди, прекрасно читаються це письмо, але історії не знають, що ми є християни православні, і що ми узнаємо Бога одного у святій Тройці, Ісуса Христа, що є Бог, дві природи, одна особа. Як прийдете на кінець, наші долі, так і зробите. Діти, не від вас, від Бога вчилися від мене, вислитися так, від вас. Так що якщо вони все не вміють, зробіть так, я хрестився. А вони не діти, як то тато і мама так, не бійте, але свій тато, чи тато те, що говорив, так має. Що обирає таким способом, цим ключем до неба, від плечі двері райські, які Бог своїм життям, своєю жертвою, своєю любов'ю нам як буде креститися? Всі ваші руки праві і вгору, прошу, put your right hands up. Three fingers together. Two fingers into your palm. Break the glue. Tie them in. Lock them in. And you cross yourself. In have been blessed in a remarkable way. God takes care of what? Drunks and fools. God works miracles when you least expect them. We came here in 1976, named the church after St. Elias. It was blessed by Bishop Isidore that we might have a community here. What courage. What insanity. Again, we're in a time where it's coming up the whole parishes that have been established already. We're going to start a parish, and yet God takes care of drunks and fools. For 4 years, you should know, for 4 years, we were serving in a school gym. Nothing like this. The altar was placed in front, and right above my head was a basketball hoop. And all around the side were cartoon figures of people doing physical exercises. So instead of icons like this, we had people doing jumping jacks and sit-ups and all sorts of other things. 4 years, St. Anne's on Bonham Street. And the overhead was minimum. Nothing, there was nothing to pay for. And then in 1980, God gave this community of St. Elias, well, we have maybe about 30 families now. He gave us the use of a cemetery chapel on McLaughlin Road. At that time, it was the edge of Brampton, a two-lane road, a country path almost. The prisoners in the reformatory there had built a church for their use. It was a make-work project. And so the guys built this church that had windows with gaps like this so that in the wintertime, well, you can always light for it in the wintertime, the snow would blow through it. The eaves were so porous that the squirrels thought that this was their home up there. The plumbing led to nowhere. You flushed the toilet and 3 times and the water would back up in the basement. Not easy, that social. Literally, the plumbing led nowhere. It was the edge of town. We were there for 15 years. It cost us $1 a year. They wanted to charge us electricity, but they said, ah, forget it, we don't know how to figure it all out. $1 a year. God takes care of who? Drunks and fools, as we say, as I love to say. God said, don't worry, God will provide, and he provided. 5 years later, we were able to buy this purchaser's property for $100,000. At that time, it was a fortune, and at that time, this was way out of town. There was concern. Why build it here? Why buy it here? This is too far away from Brampton. I wish we had gone even further away, but that's another story. We bought the land. Bishop Isidore blessed the purchase. We bought it. We paid for it. Almost immediately began planning on building the church. God sent us an architect, Paul Greenberg, God rest his soul, who gave us this vision of this church. God sent us a like-minded group of people, fundraisers. Every week we would gather to raise the funds to help build this church. God sent us parishioners who would worship in here and friends who would support us from near and far. In 1993, we were able to license this cemetery group. Not easy in this day and age of bureaucracy. We had to raise the level of the ground. The mayor waived the cost of perpetual care for us, and the cemetery was blessed in 1993. 95, the church was blessed. And we've been going strong ever since. God sent us an iconographer, Bogdan Turetsky, starting with these icons, and then up to the top. We weren't intending to do that. We didn't have the money, but he was able to. So it got down, and he started there in 10 years. The church is painted. The icons surround us and make this place of worship heaven on earth. God takes care of drunks and fools. God takes care of us here at St. Elias. Father Chodosky, in blessing us, in speaking on the occasion of this consecration of the church, said, may St. Elias Church be a beacon, as Metropolitan Andrew said,
спаси людей твоїх, і благослови спокоємство твоє, помсту церкви твоєї охорони, освіти тих, що люблять Христу Дому Твого, ти їх прослав божественною силою своєю, і не залиши нас, що надіємося на тебе. Мир селі тобі твоєму даруй церквам твоїм іреям, Богом береженому народові нашому правлінню і всім людям твоїм, бо всяке добре давання і всякий звершений дар святоти є, що сходить від тебе оце світла, і тобі славу, і подяку, і поклін засилаємо Отцю і Сину, і Святому Духові, нині повсякчас і навіки вічні.
Thank you. and of mercy. Benedict, Pope of Rome, for our most blessed patriarch, Seattle's love, our most reverend Metropolitan Lawrence, our God-loving Bishop Stephen, the God-loving Bishop Cornelius, for those who serve or have served in this holy church, for our spiritual fathers, and for all our brethren in Christ. For this nation under God, for our government, and for all the military. We also pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, and visitation for the founders, benefactors, and parishioners of this holy church. We also pray for the repose of the souls of the servants of God, the founders, benefactors, and parishioners of this holy church, who here and everywhere lie asleep in the Lord, and that they be pardoned all of their offenses, voluntary and involuntary. We also pray for the people here present who await your great and bountiful mercy, for those who have been kind to us, and for all Orthodox Christians.
Thank you.